The following day, I've traveled to a game farm that raises kudu, wildebeest, and impala. But they've got a band of baboons that has taken a liking to newborn calves. They actually rip the calves' stomachs open, then drink their mother's milk.
They're still a little apprehensive to get up near the viewing stand, which is now a hunting line. The big male baboon is further out, and there's younger males around right now that are feeding on the alfalfa. We've been here for some time, but I'm amazed at the amount of animals that have come in here to feed and water. The drought is unlike anything I've seen in Africa, and I've been hunting Africa for about 30 years. It's just, it's pulling animals from miles and miles away. But the one guy we're after today is a baboon, and he hasn't showed up yet, so. Patience.
By killing the troop's lead male, it will often convince the baboons to up and leave. So I've got my sights set for a big male baboon. He has shown up near the bait, but he is wise. Cautiously, he watches the monkeys forage in my bait. I'm using the big bore blowgun with my razor darts, so I need him close. The temptation is strong. Ultimately, it's too strong. I'm waiting for his arms to clear and give me a passage to his heart. And as he looks away, the falcon dives to its mark. Oh.